change, we'll change. It'll change if we work together. You'll change, we'll change. It'll change, connect the figures. You'll change, we'll change. It'll change if we work.
Leaving no one behind, everyone counts, is a plea for saving lives. It means that everyone is equally important once you are a resident of the tri-island state of Grenada, Carriacou, and Piti-Martinique. It is very important for persons to partake in the upcoming population and housing census, which will start from November the 1st, 2021, not only because of your civic duty and your responsibility to nation building, but simply because you count. Your voice is an important voice in our development agenda. No matter your ethnicity, religion, occupation, living conditions, occupational status, age, sex, or physical and mental abilities. It is one of the most important ways of being the change you want to see in your households, in your community, in your parish, and in your country. The census provides important information that will inform educational, health, housing, employment, social welfare, and community development policies. This opportunity for the entire population to influence national and sustainable development is a rare one, as a population and housing census is done once every 10 years. It is your choice to make a step towards that change. A population and housing census is a necessary activity in most countries, as it captures the significant changes in the population dynamics after 10 years. Indeed, it is the most important statistical undertaking of a country. COVID-19 has significantly changed our social and economic landscape, as we have lost lives, livelihoods, and income. This pandemic has affected our education, health, and general welfare. As a result of this, our population characteristics may have drastically changed. In order to plan better for your future, we need to capture this change. Our aim at the Central Statistical Office is to report statistics that are accurate, reliable, timely, and relevant, which can inform policymakers. However, we cannot fulfill our objective without your full participation in the population and housing census. In the words of our national anthem, heads, hearts, and hands in unity to reach our destiny. And may we with faith and courage aspire, build, and advance as one people, one family. This census is about unity, equality, and nation building. In addition to providing critical information, this activity will build the foundation of a strong statistical infrastructure and national statistical system for the next 10 years, as it will be used as a sample frame for most of the surveys in the intercensal years, as well as provide baseline indicators for monitoring and evaluating progress, ensuring sustainable development and building resilience. I want to assure you that the data from the census and all other statistical undertaking is collected under the Statistical Act, which is the legislation that governs our operations. We are legally obligated to ensure that all individual information collected is safe and secure, and the identity of all respondents are protected. We join the whole of CARICOM in celebrating Caribbean Statistics Day under the theme, Leaving No One Behind, Everyone Counts. We are all users of statistics. So I would like to wish everyone a happy Caribbean Statistics Day.
Hi, I'm Timon Charles, Deputy Director of the Central Statistical Office, Grenada. As we celebrate Caribbean Statistics Day, I would like to wish everyone a happy Caribbean Statistics Day and to let you know what the office is currently doing. The Central Statistical Office has been incorporating the use of technology in its operations. There's a revamped website where many of our users can get various statistical information. The website is stats.gov.gd. Lately, the office has been using various statistical software and programming language to process many of its data for analysis. Some of these programs and languages are as follows: Stata, SPSS, R Programming, and Python. We have also employed various experts with programming background and technical capacity to work to meet the increasing demands of data. Over the years, we have been using mobile devices for data collection for most of our surveys and incorporating GIS for field activities and data dissemination. This year, we will be conducting our first digital census by using mobile devices to collect data from respondents via telephone, and in some instances, face-to-face, adhering to all COVID-19 safety protocols. The IT data processing and geographic information section of the office is collaborating with an EU consultant and Esri, leading providers of GIS service. We're able to extract building footprints from Grenada's LiDAR imagery. The survey department will undertake a pre-census activity to update the footprints by taking the GPS coordinates of new buildings erected in the last 3 years. This is an important aspect of our census preparation to ensure that we have full coverage and that we can have an inventory of all buildings and its location for enumeration for census day. We will also be collecting telephone numbers from all our households, since the main mode of this census will be via telephone, which was a decision to minimize the face-to-face contact. It is very important for the general public to give us its full cooperation. I must also reiterate that at the Central Statistical Office, we always place significant emphasis on security and confidentiality of respondents' data. Using the electronic approach to data collection, we have added another security feature where data once entered on the tablets are automatically encrypted. Hence, no unauthorized individual can have access to it. This is in addition to the oath of confidentiality taken by all census staff. Hence, I would like to reassure the public that information that will be collected will only be shared on an aggregated basis for policy decision purposes, and that information cannot be disseminated in a way that discloses the identity of anyone. This is against our Census Act and against the census regulation. Hence, persons who commit this offense can be fined. As we reflect on this theme of Caribbean Statistics Day, I would like to highlight the need for data for evidence-based planning and decision-making to change and improve people's lives. Just as census team states, nothing about us without us. Take the time to think about the data that you provide today and how we can shape the future for tomorrow, keeping in mind that no one should be left behind.
Hi, my name is Rachel Jacob, and I'm with the Census and Survey section. The team within this section has direct responsibility for the administrative and data collection aspect of censuses and surveys. In recent times, we have conducted surveys such as quarterly labor force survey, survey of living condition, which is a poverty measurement survey, labor market needs assessment surveys, women health and life experience, among others. The office undertakes a population and housing census every 10 years. The last one was done in 2011. It therefore means that 2021 is a census year. What a year to conduct a census. COVID-19 has indeed presented a challenge to the census team. However, like other government agencies producing a public good and a service, which in our case is official statistics, we rose to the occasion, made the necessary adjustment to the census instrument and the procedures, and we are now prepared to launch our field activities within the coming weeks. One of the main reasons we are forging ahead with our census plan is because as an office, in keeping with the motto of Caribbean Statistics Day of leaving no one behind, we understand the importance and have accepted the mandate of having current data to aid in planning and policy development for the benefit of all Grenadians, especially information needed for planning us through and out of this pandemic. Data produced from the census are used by a wide range of organizations locally, regionally, and internationally. It informs all sorts of social and economic development, policy formulation, business ventures, as well as being widely used by researchers and academia. But the census cannot be done by the statistical office alone. Why? Because census is about people, who we are, what we do, where we live, what are our accomplishments, and what are our needs and challenges are. Our census motto, I think you know what it is by now, says count us because we all count. And we are coming to your home, your business, your businesses, institutions, so we can account for our entire population. This year's census would be our first paperless census. We would be using a CAPI, which is a computer-assisted personal interview, and CATI, computer-assisted telephone interview approach to data collection. Because of the pandemic, most of our interviews would be done over the telephone. Interviewers would come to your home with their face shields, masks, security jackets, and identification card to briefly collect limited information that would allow them to properly identify your location and get contact information to complete the interview. They would leave you a contact card with their number so you can verify the number that is calling you to conduct the interview. If you are not at home, a callback card would be left with the name and number of the interviewer that you can call, you can text, send a WhatsApp message indicating the time you are available to conduct the interview. We are soliciting your support and cooperation with our enumerators to make this a success. Please note that strict measures has been put in place to ensure that even through the various mediums of data collection, all of your data remains confidential. I strongly encourage everyone to complete the census questionnaire. As we celebrate Caribbean Statistics Day, and as we prepare to undertake this activity of national importance, we want to remind you of the theme, leave no one behind because everyone counts.
We call on you, all of you out there, every man, woman, and child of every race, creed, and calling to stand up and be counted in the upcoming census. Participation is the key since the future started yesterday.
If you hear this message, wherever you stand, I'm calling every woman, I'm calling every man. We're the generation, we can't afford to wait. The future started yesterday, and we're already late. We've been looking for a song to sing, search for a melody, search for someone to lead on. We've been looking for the world to change, if you feel the same. tomorrow starting now. No more broken promises, no more call to war, unless it's love and peace that we're really fighting for. We can destroy hunger, we can conquer hate, put down your arms and raise your voice, we're joining hands today.
I was looking for a song to sing.
Search for a leader.
Hi everyone, I am Karen Richards, attached to the Economic Unit of the Central Statistical Office. Here in statistics, we do a lot of compilation, and today I want to share with you the use of the census data in compiling GDP. Census data is very critical in developing reliable assessment of the economic well-being of our country. The gross domestic per capita income is a core indicator of economic performance and commonly used as a broad measure of the average living standards or economic well-being of our country. It is calculated by dividing Grenada's total GDP by its population. The estimated average income earned per year, in this case, well, I'll share with you, earned in 2019 and 2020. In 2019, it was $22,115, and in 2020, $18,932. This indicates a decline of 14.3%, which can be attributed to job losses during the pandemic. Data from the census is also used as a statistical tool for benchmarking and forecasting trends. For example, the population and housing data is used in the calculation of the real estate and renting sector of the GDP. The data can also be used to estimate sectors with data gaps. On this note, I would want to end here by wishing everyone a happy Caribbean Statistics Day.
Hello, my name is Cassandra Julian. I'm attached to the Social and Demographic Unit of the office. In accordance to this year's slogan for Caribbean Statistics Day, Leave No One Behind, as a unit, we are responsible for the compilation and dissemination of data on health, population projections and estimates, vital statistics, which includes, for example, fertility rate, mortality rate, life expectancy, birth rate, marriages, divorces, to name a few. How does the census impact our work? Most of the data we collect are through administrative sources disaggregated by parish and sex. From the census, we will be able to get comprehensive and detailed data on the whole population by the lowest administrative or geographical level, in our case, communities and villages, and related rates and indicators such as growth rate, age and gender composition, educational features. The population count from the census will provide a more precise baseline for the computation of our rates, and it will also strengthen the accuracy of the population projections going forward. We compare the census data with our administrative sources for the period to measure quality and accuracy. Rates such as crude mortality rate, which is the number of deaths per 1,000 population, total fertility rate, which is the total number of children that would be born to a woman during her lifetime, and infant mortality rates, the number of deaths to infants under 1 per 1,000 population, can be used to assess the strength of our healthcare and influence policy and planning. The birth and death rate are functions of the age distribution in a population. Over the years, our deaths have been increasing and our births have decreased, which has caused slow population growth. If this trend continues, it can result in an aging population. Our unit is also responsible for measuring a number of SDG indicators for the monitoring of the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. The census will provide data for a number of indicators under some of the SDG goals. For example, goal 3, which is ensure healthy lives and promote well-being for all ages. The indicators are coverage of health services and under 5 mortality rate. Goal 5, which is achieve gender equality and empower all women and girls. The indicators are the proportion of time spent on unpaid domestic and care work by sex, age, and location, and the number of women in managerial positions. Goal 8, decent work and economic growth. The indicators, unemployment rate by sex, age, and persons with disabilities, and the proportion of youth aged 15 to 24 years not in education, employment, or training. In keeping with our census motto, count us because we all count, I want to encourage each and every one of us to participate, respond to the enumerators when they come to your households, because the information you collect would benefit us Grenadians and also help us to plan for the future.
Now, a census is done every 10 years, and now that as we commemorate Caribbean Statistics Day, I just want to share some of the questions that are collected in the census that are actually pertaining or relative to environmental statistics. And one of the questions is the type of fluid used most for cooking. And basically there are a few options which are available, whether you use the wood, charcoal, kerosene, electricity, gas, solar energy, or biogas. Another question related to the environment is the ways of garbage disposal, whether it's dumping, whether you use the garbage truck, whether you burn, whether you compost, whether you dump in the river or the sea, the pond, whether you bury, or any other means that you may use in order to dispose of your garbage. Then there are other information gathered, which basically will have to be used in order to determine what we call sustainable development goals. And that include the source of water. This indicator will actually look at the standard of living. So they like to know whether they and what is the source of water. Whether the water is reach certain characteristics, whether the water is pumped into the dwelling, whether you use standpipe, whether you use chalk bone water, private catchment, for example, rainwater, or any other source of water supply. Then another question deals with the source of lighting, which also has to deal with the environment. Whether they get it from Green Lake, electricity from Green Lake, whether the person have private generator, whether the lighting is generated from solar source, whether it's from gas, lantern, kerosene, or candle. And there are other environmental issues which will be related to the community in terms of waste disposal, whether water is contaminated, drainage, air pollution, use of pesticides, deforestation, destruction of mangrove, soil erosion, squatting, flooding, cell phone towers, noise, coastal erosion, land seepage, and other. And there are other information which are collected from the census, which are used in the publication of the Environmental Statistical Compendium, which is produced every 2 years. For example, information on the population and information on health, basically. These information are also collected in order to generate indicators in the Environmental Compendium.
We want you to get ready. The whole of the Chai Island for the housing census 2021. Yeah, this is a call to the nation. I have some information. It's important. I want everyone join us in support of the census. So come here, let's count the population to give the right amount.
As a Director of Economic and Technical Cooperation within the Ministry of Finance, statistics that is collected by the census will furnish us with information at the granular level. And when I say granular level, all the details, household distribution, income distribution, it looks at male and female composite within the household, population. It looks at how the population is distributed, age, So you look at gender. So it takes into consideration all the relevant information that are necessary when you're looking at economic development, you're looking at infrastructural development, you're looking at just the growth of society as a whole, where we are. If we're talking about mitigation and adaptation strategies, statistics will help and facilitate. It look at how the household are distributed throughout which area, the lowland area, the seacoast area, what you're going to see exactly. So when you're looking at the impact of climate change, for example, you will see the area, the potential housing stock that will be affected. And that will give you some information for coming up with mitigation, coming up with strategies to see how best we can protect life, safeguard individuals throughout the island of Grenada. So the information is very important. In the development of project, as mentioned earlier, you need the statistics. During the implementation of the project, you need statistics. And also when you're doing your postmortem of the project, you need statistics, because they all speak to what is happening. So it is relevant, it is necessary, and it has become the backbone of decision making, of policy development, of intervention, of investment. So statistics is critical, it is relevant, and is necessary for economic development and for growth locally, regionally, and internationally.
Leaving no one behind, everyone comes. This theme adequately captures the importance of inclusiveness in our quest towards achieving sustainable development. When government takes decisions or implements policies, it is important that all relevant information is presented to ensure that no one is left out of the decision-making process. Government's policies are most effective when they are based on reliable and accurate information. As you may know, Grenada is currently embarking on its national population and housing census, the first after many years. The most accurate census is the one where the entire population partakes. With data from everyone, decisions can be tailored to the needs of the entire population, and so government's scarce resources are optimized. Now, the population and housing census is one of the most important planning instruments for any government, as it establishes critical baseline indicators at the smallest geographical level that will chart the way forward for development in communities, parishes, and the country for the next 10 years. It is the only survey instrument that collects information on the entire population. Therefore, it is the most accurate source of information on a country's demographic, health, educational, employment, and housing characteristics. At the Macroeconomic Policy Unit, we analyze Grenada's key economic indicators and recommend policies that not only promote sustainable economic development, but a good standard of living for the population. The population figure itself is used as an important denominator in a few economic indicators, such as per capita income, debt to population ratio, and government expenditure per capita. The census also captures data on an individual's gross income and allows for information to be presented on the country's income distribution, which is an important economic indicator of welfare. These are some of the important economic statistical indicators analyzed by the policy unit to assess economic performance.
Leave no one behind, everyone comes. This is the essence of what the census, the national census, is all about. We need the need for high quality, timely, reliable, and relevant demographic data so that the government and other policymakers and program developers will have the necessary information for the economic and social development of the country. The idea of leaving no one behind is what is very important. So it is really an appeal to every Grenadian to ensure that he or she is counted, from the babies to the oldest person in the country. Why is it important that we need to that information? For developmental purposes. If you think about the pandemic and what has happened in the pandemic in Grenada, for example,
or even if you think about the current government efforts at poverty reduction, you will understand the importance of ensuring that everyone is included, including the babies. Think about a baby born this month or this year. In 10 years' time, that child is going to be 10 years old. And with that, for planning purposes, we would need to know in terms of school, in terms of healthcare, etc., where funds should be deployed, in which communities, what is the situation in each household, etc. So the census and ensuring that everyone is included is so very important. I cannot emphasize enough how important it is. What it means for my line of work, I am a research sociologist. I am professor of research at St. George's University. And we make full use of the Central Statistics Office, the data that is contained there. So if our students are doing a mapping of the community, or if they're doing any type of project, that it must involve having the background information, understanding the social and economic situation of our people. So it is essential that they have the numbers. They understand that in order to plan any type of project, to get involved in any type of developmental activities, you need the data. We need to know what number of people living in Grenada, what is the size of the household, what's the ages of the persons, what's the sex of the population, etc. So all of that information is extremely critical to get any type of developmental work done. Without that information, it will be straight guesswork and prone to failure. Thank you.
Life is a circle in which we all play a part. That circle is shortened by death and widened by new life. This affects the population and brings home to us the need for a census, especially at this time.
From the day we arrived on the planet, Lincoln steps into the sun. There's more to see than can ever be seen, more to do than can ever be done. Some say eat or be eaten. Some say live and let live. All are agreed as they join the stampede. You should never take more than you give in the circle of life. Is the wheel of fortune in the leap of fate? Is the far too much to take in here. that can never be found. But the sun rolling high through the sapphire sky keeps great and small on the endless round in the circle of life. Is the wheel of fortune.
Carrie Grenade. I'm a consultant in the Ministry of Finance in Grenada. Happy Caribbean Statistics Day 2021. As we reflect on the theme, I think it's a crucially important one because it speaks to equality, inclusion, equity, togetherness. These are all important aspects and pillars of sustainable development and important manifestations of economic development that is sustainable. And the data and statistics, especially our census data, will reveal where we are, will manifest where we are in terms of our social and economic and environmental progress, areas in which we are doing well and we need to applaud ourselves as a country and a region, and areas where we need to take action to improve the social and economic well-being of our people, because we all matter, we all count, and we need to ensure that we are taking all the right actions so that each one will benefit from the prosperity and progress that we so all desire, because no one should be left behind. We are in this together. Together, we are stronger. Thank you. Happy Caribbean Statistics Day 2021.
As a public health professional who relies on evidence to make decisions, statistics form an important part of my teaching, research, and practice in the prevention and control of diseases among populations. This year's Caribbean Statistics Day theme, Leave No One Behind, Everyone Counts, means prioritizing the human rights of all of our citizens, but ensuring that our most marginalized communities are counted. Our women and girls, people with disabilities, youth, the elderly, lesbian, gays, bisexual, and transgender populations as we strive to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals by 2030. During this COVID-19 pandemic, we've all become very familiar with COVID-19 statistics on confirmed new infections, deaths, and vaccine doses administered. While these data are important, statistics on cancers, heart diseases, diabetes, hypertension, overweight and obesity continues to be important. These diseases or conditions put us at risk of severe COVID-19 infection. and an association has been identified between COVID-19 and the onset of some of these chronic conditions. In my work, statistics are important to determine whether people are able to and have equitable access to health services, essential medicines, and support services during the pandemic to prevent sickness, disability, and death from other causes and the barriers they may be facing. Prior to the COVID-19 pandemic, we know that 1 in 3 women globally and in Grenada have experienced intimate partner violence in their lifetime. In my work, statistics are important in determining how much this problem has worsened during the pandemic and the association between the pandemic and violence against women and girls, which segments of the population are most affected, as well as victims' and survivors' access to health and support services. Statistics are important in my work on sexual and reproductive health and rights. For example, to determine fertility rates among women in the Caribbean. Are women and their partners delaying or choosing not to have children? And is this related to the pandemic? Has access to comprehensive sexuality education decreased due to school closures and online classes? How has the pandemic affected previous gains made in access to family planning and HIV services? Without the evidence base that statistics provide about these pressing public health challenges, governments and civil society organizations cannot perform their duty to effectively serve the people. The current round of census in Grenada and CARICOM is an opportunity for everyone to get counted. The census provides the foundational data required for our health and other systems to reorient their planning, budgeting, policies, and service delivery to begin to remedy the deleterious effects of the COVID-19 pandemic. Let's ensure everyone is counted today.
Leave no one behind means that you want the entire population, all sectors of the population, farmers, fishers, all householders, to be part of the census. And that's important because it means that government will need this information, development institution will need this information for planning and other purposes. If you don't know what you have or you don't know your status, how can you adequately plan and prepare for that future? So it's a very critical situation, and this is why all, the entire population, should in fact be prepared and participate in the census. Of course, a census is important for the work we are involved in here. We're a development institution, a rural development agency, and our work is directed towards poverty alleviation. So if we need to know the status, we need to know how many single-headed households there are. We need to know what is the economic status of the farmers. We need to know the household incomes. We need this information so that when we are applying for development aid, development assistance, we can make the argument, we can make the justification that this is our reality. This is a fact, and the data that is collected from a census is in fact what we are using, what we'll be using, because you have to show evidence that in fact this is the status of your country. This is in fact the socio-economic, social status of your country. And it's critical that you have the information, up-to-date information, to make that justification and make that argument so you can draw in development assistance for livelihoods, for community development, for infrastructure development, for farmers and other sectors in the rural economy in particular. So it's critical that we have up-to-date data, up-to-date information. Everyone benefits from this information. Thank you.
All over the world, people have died and are still dying from the COVID-19 virus. But we now have an opportunity to care for the living by getting information about their needs from the upcoming census. This will be used to make Grenada a better place. So let the healing begin.
Thank you. And I know that it is love. This place can be much brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place, you'll feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there. If you care enough for the living, make a little space.
You the world. have some information. It's important. I want everyone join us in support of the census. So come here, let's go.
The theme for Caribbean Statistics Day commits decision makers and the users and producers of statistics to analysis and use of data to determine how much progress has been made in a country in order to ensure no one is left behind. UN Women prioritizes gender statistics for this purpose, and with a view to supporting member states to close the largest gender data gaps in our region. In CARICOM, these include data on unpaid care and domestic work, and I'm very pleased to share that UN Women has been collaborating with the Grenada Statistics Office to measure unpaid care and domestic work in the labor force survey and also in the housing and population census, which is currently taking place. Another significant gender data gap in CARICOM is on violence against women and girls. And I'm also pleased to share that we are inching very closely to closing this data gap, although only 5 countries in the region have completed these surveys, and UN Women and a suite of other partners have been involved in the conduct of these surveys. Finally, another significant gender data gap is on sexual and reproductive health and rights. Filling these data gaps would allow for an accurate assessment of the progress made by CARICOM member states on gender equality, which is necessary for building back better after the COVID-19 pandemic and the achievement of the Sustainable Development Goals and regional and national development goals as well. The census is the single most important data collection initiative for a country. Policymakers need to know how many people are in a country. Such information can guide policymakers in determining the allocation of resources to address the problems identified and to support national development. Equally important is the analysis of census data. This is important for the work UN Women does. Data on where women and men are located, their respective access to and use of critical resources can uncover inequalities. Also, when we can compare this data with information from previous census rounds, we are able to assess how much progress has been made. I would encourage countries to commit to not only completing the field work and collecting the raw data from the census, but to actually ensuring its timely release. The census is not complete until the data are made public and available for analysis, including gender analysis.
Caribbean Statistics Day 2021, leave no one behind, everyone counts. It means that the Central Statistical Office, in its collection, management, and analysis of data, will always target every individual member of a household who lives in a particular community within a particular parish in the Tri-Island state of Grenada, Carriacou, and Petite Martinique. Now, how does this work and how does this benefit the Department of Economic and Technical Cooperation? Project objectives are always to provide services to a community, and it is usually a specific geographical area. The Central Statistical Office would then provide information through the census, household surveys, and other means to the project to make sure that the targeted interventions will reach the appropriate individuals where it is most needed. Thank you.
During this present pandemic, COVID, the use of statistics is especially important as it allows us to get an idea of just how much of our population has been affected and in what way. This then allows the government to make well-informed decisions for the safety and protection of our country. And with this, I remind you to wear your mask, wash your hands, and follow the protocols. As we celebrate this Caribbean Statistics Day, with the theme again being Leave No One Behind, Everyone Counts, this means to me that the needs of all will be taken into consideration for the benefit of our society. Happy Caribbean Statistics Day to all.
Pass on the word. Mothers to daughters. Fathers to sons. To the hungry and to the hopeless. That help is at hand. Help given with care. Help given with love.
Please give a helping hand, don't shun, to guide all of us together.
Hi, I'm Dr. Sonia Nixon, And I am a general practitioner and a public health consultant here in Grenada. October 15th is Caribbean Statistics Day, and how important this is to us. Recently, we've had a lot of talk about data and people complaining everything is data, data, data. But it's the data that makes us understand exactly how we plan our lives. Information or data that's appropriately collected, that's correctly analyzed, scientifically analyzed by statistical specialists, is often translated into new information that guides all our plans. And so it's by no accident that the theme for this year is Leave No One Behind, Everyone Counts. And we ask to tell about ourselves as we start our new census in the next couple of weeks. Now, in the last year, we've heard a lot about data. We've had a lot of challenges with this pandemic. We've collected a lot of information. We've said where we lived, whether or not we're allergic to vaccines. We've seen how many people have died. We've seen how many people have survived, and every day, we've seen the Ministry of Health provide information that's analyzed, that's put into packages and shared. When we all tell what is happening to us, what petrol we use, what car we drive, what do we earn, where do we live, how often we get sick, what do we need from the hospital, what do we need to eat, what do we buy in the supermarket, it gives the people who lead, the people who buy food, who sell food, a better idea, a better understanding of exactly what they must get in order so a population can live well. The Ministry of Health understands how should they plan for our health in the future. Do we need more beds? Do we need more doctors? Do we need more nurses? Do we need more lab technicians? What level of training people need to have in order to reach what is necessary to ensure that this population is happy, that our lives are at the level we required. Do we have too many cars on the road? Do we have enough cars? Is our public transportation system effective? Those are the things that go into data, and once they're correctly analyzed, we understand exactly how our lives should be organized. We understand better what are the good things that are happening, what we need to eliminate, and how we're going to make Grenadians happy according to their needs. Congratulations to all the statistical officers who work every day to put information together so that we can do better, so that our country can, plans can be made for a better running of our country.
Grenada. You to get ready, the whole of the Chai Island for the housing census 2021, yeah. This is a call to the nation, I have some information. It's important, I want everyone join.